bit, and so he hit the eight ball really hard, and it went right in. So
yeah, that was an easy win.
Nama from the Outpost Motel, Dolores, Colorado. Tomorrow morning is the third of four Southwest Nordic Cup races. Trying to defend my title. I'm way off the back. If you've been following the vlog, then you realize that I didn't even think I was going to be racing this year. So I'm barely, I don't know where I'm at. It's hard to even find out where I'm at in the series. So, but I'm going to go down fighting in defense of my title. That's Dewa over my right shoulder there. And we're chilling here, getting an early night's rest for the races tomorrow. I'm going to be doing the 15K skate. Want to express my disappointment again. There's no classic races to determine the Southwest Nordic Cup overall series champion. How can you have the best Nordic skier if you don't test them in all the disciplines, all the distances? There should be sprint races, there should be ultra marathons, classic skate, but it's a start and it's good. So yeah, Outpost Motel, very cool little cabin. And looking forward to some sacred sweat, and let's do this thing. Out until tomorrow. Woke up on race day. You just never know what's gonna happen. So Dewa's throat, which began getting sore 2 days ago, was no better this morning in Dolores. So we're benching her for this weekend. This is not an important race for her. What's important for her is the Junior National Qualifier next weekend in Soldier Hollow, Utah. So we've benched her. I'm up at the course pre-skiing. And I'll knock out the 15K, go back and take care of her, keep her healthy as possible for next week. The course looks beautiful. Check it out. So I've got two skis with different waxes on. On my left is LF5, the colder one. On my right is LF6, slightly warmer. And what's deceptive about this course is over my left shoulder, a lot of the course is in the shade, which is much colder. So it's gonna be a kind of a throw up between which ski I'm gonna ski on. Ski a couple more Ks here. Use my intuitive wisdom to feel which ski is going to be fastest over the most of the course. So, come on, let's see how this goes. I've intersected back onto the race course, and this is part of the railroad grid, the famous Galloping Goose trail that goes from the top of, it goes everywhere, dude. Lizard Head Pass, Telluride, absolutely world famous. But here's what's the thing about this course, even though this is a downhill, I still have to skate it. So there's no resting the legs anywhere on this course. And yeah, it's start finish is right over my left shoulder. And got some knee cracking steep little rollers. No sustained climbs, but man, it adds up. And remember, we're 10,000 feet, so every effort you make, you're not gonna recover from. So you only have so many matches to burn in 15 kilometers here. So it's gonna be brutal. It's gonna be beautiful. What I like to call brutiful. Feeling very blessed. Thanks for coming along. Final set of rollers before the stadium start finish here. Come on. Mission accomplished, baby. That hurts so bad. It hurts so good. It was indeed brutal. Now I'm sitting here in Black Thunder with some sweet green chili and waiting on awards. Absolutely fantastic. Oh my God, that hurts so bad. I did good. Got in an epic battle with a longtime Nordic legend up here and course groomer Bill Dilios. I forget. Sorry, Bill. We went back and forth, and I knew I had him on the glide and timed it on the railroad. Used my classic devil pull, came around him with about a kilometer to go, not even, and held him off. I had to out sprint for the finish, and it was awesome. So, good day out. And I want to thank you guys for coming along, inspiring me. I got to get back to my beautiful girl. Hope her throat's feeling better. Thank you, Sandra, for taking a pull there. And, yeah, moved up a bit in the series, so all's good. Just keep towing those start lines and learn about your higher self. Otherwise, hey, stagnation. So, proud of you. Nama, get out and do so as to be.